Winslow's Tavern. We're at Winslow's Tavern in Welfleet, Massachusetts with Tracey Hunt. You're the manageress or the owner or?
Yes, depending on who's asking and when.
Oh,
my family
okay.
knows the business and I'm the general manager.
Wow. Oh, you're the general manager and you're a descendant of the Mayflower.
I am.
Does that mean you're a pilgrim or?
Yes, a long and illustrious lineage, leading all the way back, 16th generation, descendant.
16, wow.
16, on my mother's side, to Edward Winslow. And it's a little known fact, well, it's a well-known fact on the Outer Cape, that the Pilgrims visited and explored the Outer Cape before they went to Plymouth.
Right.
They were in Provincetown and Welfleet. So that's how we got the name, Winslow's Tavern.
Right, and he said, which I guess you like it here, and your family's liked it here for 16 generations, so you're still here in Welfleet.
Well, we're not that native or local. That's a sort of unique distinction for people in Welfleet or the Outer Cape to be truly local. Technically, I'm a Washashore. I didn't grow up here, but I have made Welfleet my home for the last 11 years and summered here my whole life.
So. Yeah. This is a picture, if we can get this, of Tracey and her husband, Philip, who run this place, I guess, and there's Winslow's Tavern.
Yeah, Philip's in the kitchen.
Oh, he's a chef.
So we're a husband and wife team. He's South African born.
That's great.
So he's definitely not local.
Oh, he's definitely not local. No. But now, tell us about your menu. You're having a prefix dinner tonight and many other things too. It's too overwhelming for me to just glance at and know what to say.
Tonight is Porchetta Sunday, which we do Sundays in June.
Porchetta?
Porchetta Sunday.
What's
that's
that?
A whole roast suckling pig.
Oh my God.
And
yes.
That speaks to Philip's carnivorous tendencies and his love of Italy.
Okay.
So we're doing Porchetta Sunday, and
but mainly you're known as a seafood restaurant.
We are. No. This is kind of a departure for us because it's something fun we can do mm-hmm. on Sundays in June, like an Italian Sunday supper, and then he gets to do more inventive things that we wouldn't normally offer. So typically, I would describe the menu as obviously heavily seasonally and coastally inspired, but
yes.
You'll see some of Philip's South African background with the curried mussels, which we're going to see.
Oh, okay.
A little bit. That was Philip's take on local seafood. He had to put curry in.
I love it.
Because he was born and raised in Durban, which has a huge continental Indian population. So that's an influence. And the roast oysters. Which I'll also send out, the miso and chive roast oysters.
Wow.
That's another one of Philip's sort of take on local seafood. Could he spin it in a different direction and do something with it?
Well, the Welfleet oyster, I mean, you go to Manhattan to the oyster bar, that's what they're serving is Welfleet, you know?
Yeah, we have the best in the world.
I didn't really realize it was a place until the film festival had a venue here, and I went, Welfleet, oysters, it's real, yeah.
So you're gonna have some. It's hard to improve the classic Welfleet oyster
right.
because they're fantastic.
Right.
They're really the best in the world.
And they just come from, like, down the street somewhere.
They do. Everyone's very proud of the specific grants where the oysters come from.
Wow,
so.
Wow. I love it. And thank you very much for having us here as your guest. Today on the Stephen Holt Show, my goal is to make them very hungry.
Good.
When I eat.
Good.
People like to watch me eat. I don't know. It was a hidden talent that's come to the fore.
Well, I love passionate diners, and I love people who are cinephiles.
Well, that's me too, and I'm sorry you're not getting to see any of the excellent movies that they've had at the Provincetown Film Festival this year. And this is the last night of it. After this, we do the award show at, I forget what, it's a disco
Which,
in Provincetown.
Sadly,
yeah.
I'm missing that party, that fabulous party as well. But hats off to the Provincetown Film Festival because it's not internationally accredited. They do really
yes.
showcase some wonderful things, and
yes.
I know they've had John Waters has been involved and some really talented, amazing people that they
yes.
honor. So it's fantastic for the Outer Cape, and we're all, speaking for other business owners, we're all really grateful.
Yes, and now it's right across the street.
Yeah, Preservation Hall. We have very good friends at Preservation Hall, so we're happy to see.
What's the story in Preservation Hall, if you have a second to tell? It's not a church, really.
It was a Catholic church many years ago, long time ago. It was Our Lady of Lourdes, a Catholic church, 60s, 70s. 80s, and then it was sort of abandoned.
Okay.
And there was a big push to take over the space, renovate it, and this was all happening just about the time that I left Manhattan to come up here. And so we tried to step in, you know, the whole community was really galvanized by this effort to create a community art center, cultural center.
Which is a wonderful thing.
They've done an amazing job. They really have. And with each passing year, it expands, and now working with
the audience today for this film, which was called Call Me Lucky, two standing ovations.
Wow.
Two. Such an enthusiastic audience, and the film was wonderful. I don't want to go into Bobcat Goldthwait, the comedian, changed directions in his career, kind of, and went into film direction, and we've talked to them extensively about it, but anyway, it's two standing ovations in this little church basement. The audience went wild.
That's amazing. You definitely, it's now on my winter viewing list.
I hope so. I hope it gets distribution. I think they're not announcing the distributor yet, so. But you also have a background in documentary filmmaking.
I do. I'm a recovering type A producer myself. So
me too.
I haven't recovered. Yeah, I'm sort of in recovery because I do it seasonally.
I
got filmed to do restaurant management. So.
So do you work on your films during the slow months in the winter?
No, because now the restaurant has sort of become all consuming. When I first
left New York. That's what happens with restaurants.
Yeah, if you want to do it well, you really have to be incredibly hands on. And once you're out of New York, I mean, I was still doing some writing. I still have some ideas, but I have two small sons. And,
oh my God! Yeah. How old are they?
9 and 7.
You've got your hands full.
I do. I have to monitor now what the films that they're making on their iPad.
Oh dear. Uh-oh. Yeah. Okay.
And technology's so different. I've been out for 10 years. I mean,
I know. It's just changing by the week. My cameraman, Phil, has a phone. I don't know if we can show that. Or you don't want to show you. He's got a phone. No, on your wrist.
It's a video camera.
It's a video camera.
I was working on a production, my first big film in New York, on an Aton 16mm, shooting 11-minute mags on a two-hour documentary. I mean, that now
those
is
days are gone.
So obsolete.
Gone. Yeah.
Recording on an HHB DAT machine. Carrying, lugging that around.
Yes.
I remember.
I've been on the air continuously for 28 years.
Yeah. It's lighter and faster and easier, which is great.
But I don't know how to do it, and the station's going digital later this year. I'm like, oh my God, now I have to learn how to use CyberDuck.
This is
a brand new world, Tracey.
I would rather clear tables.
Oh, okay.
I shudder to think. Yeah, I would have to completely relearn everything.
I know,
so.
I'm going to have to do this.
Yeah.
It's essential, but I like eating. In the meantime, here we are at one of the most fabulous restaurants. Everyone's recommended you. I mean, everybody. Winslow'sTavern and Welfleet. Everybody, you must come here. What's the address in the website? And
we are centrally located right in the heart of Welfleet, right next to Town Hall.
Mm-hmm.
So we're 316 Main Street. We're easy to find. You can't miss us. It's a historic building. Just a quick note about that.
The building dates
to the 1840s.
Wow.
It was the former governor of Massachusetts. It was his summer residence, and in the 1920s he entertained President Calvin Coolidge here. So there is a lot of historical significance. It is not haunted, I can assure you.
Oh, okay.
That.
Okay.
A lot of people try to make those claims, but I'm here about 90 hours a week and I can tell you it's not haunted.
And you're right across the street from Preservation Hall,
yes.
Which is now the go-to place at the Provincetown Festival.
Yes, the wealthy hotspot.
Yeah, I was like, what are you doing in Wealthy? What's going on here? And then this is the second time I've been there. It's irresistible.
It's amazing.
It's amazing. You're amazing, Tracey.
Well, are you hungry?
Yes, I'm starving.
That's why you're here.
Well, thank you for having us.
So, the first thing, I'm going to send out some of the curry mussels.
Okay.
A little bit of the South African influence. And our roast oysters, which were featured in Town & Country magazine, which we're very proud of.
Do we need to show?
We'll take it from there.
need to hold this book up if you want even more information. It's the Cape Cod Chef's Table. That sounds very important.
We've got some great friends in there, so we're honored to be a part of, you know, there's some really talented and wonderful people on the Cape. So.
Okay. So Jacob, what have we here?
Well, you have our Riesling curry mussels. It's about a pound and, you know, a quarter of local mussels in a Riesling curry sauce with some crostini over the top. It is absolutely spectacular. And it's something that's been on the menu since day one. It's been incredibly popular, and people will request more and more bread to sop up the delicious Riesling curry sauce, and it is really something special.
And over here?
We have our miso broiled oysters. Obviously, this being Welfleet, these are Welfleet oysters. We'd be very in the wrong to do anyone else, even East Ham just down the road. But with a little
these
bit
of real Welfleet oysters.
They are the genuine article.
Yep,
broiled just a little bit of miso, cooks down and cooks the oyster itself. It's really, really spectacular. A little butter sauce as well.
I'm gonna try one.
Absolutely.
Guess it's like this is the best way.
But don't miss that sauce.
Oh, the sauce, of course. Delicious, delicious. And there's kind of a Spanish, Portuguese flair to this?
Oh, yes. Well, the Cape is filled with a lot of folks from Cape Verde and Portugal, you know, sort of the history of whaling in the area. So a lot of those flavors commingle here, and it's, you know, part and parcel to the sort of culture and the food culture in Cape Cod.
And I'm going to try one of these lovely mussels. My God, they're gigantic. Look, that's the biggest mussel I've ever seen in my life. Yum, yum. Oh, that's great. So, Jacob, you're in the theater, and you also work in Washington, which I ventured down to this winter, and I haven't said it on the air, but I got to see Dave Quay in The Tempest down at the...
at Shakespeare Theater.
Yes. And he was great in it, as Stefano, a role you wouldn't think would walk off with the play. But
no, but there's some
but
wonderful
did. Did
material.
See, did you
oh,
see
yeah,
it?
Yeah,
oh,
yeah,
you
yeah.
did
it's,
see it.
There's Stefano and Trinculo, you know, the sort of bumbling brothers.
Yeah.
They are notable roles, and the sort of role that any, you know, Shakespearean actor, you know, would love to play. It's a very
so you want to be a director?
Yes, I spent 4 years in Washington working for various theaters. Shakespeare Theater, the Folger, Studio Theater. I spent 2 seasons with them.
There's a lot of theater down there.
Yes, it's the second largest equity community in the country.
Really?
Yes.
So what are you doing up here?
Well, I got into grad school at DePaul
to
study directing. So Tracey Hunt, who's the owner here, is a friend of mine, and I'm coming back for the summer to do my homework before I go back to school and earn a little bit of money.
Okay. Well, thank you for bringing all this over, and this rosé is just delish.
Good.
So
I have a crab cake for you. So
oh,
right
okay. We'll be right back. And this?
This is our Maryland lump crab cake. Of course, Maryland, very well known for seafood as well, and we would be sort of much remiss not to include their offerings in our fare. It's exquisite crab cake, large chunks of Maryland crab with a really beautiful celery salad on the side.
Okay.
Don't miss any of the dill sauce as well.
All right. Mmm. Good for Maryland.
Yeah, they do good work. Yeah. So that was the beautiful thing about being in Maryland is I could get a little bit of the crab and the, you know, they have their own oysters down there. Those Chesapeakes aren't so bad.
No, they're not.
They're not a Welfleet, that's for sure.
Right.
So they're pretenders compared to Welfleet.
Okay, great. Thank you very much.
Absolutely.